services. C, a personal mentor. D, professional athletes. E, firefighters or police officers. You know what? I'm gonna go with firefighters and police officers. Because, I don't look up to a parent or family member. B, members of the armed forces. I guess it could have been one of these. It could have been either one. I don't really have a personal mentor. And D, not really. Two, so let's move on. Number two, what category do most of your fears fall into? Oh, what a deep question. A, spiders, snakes, creepy crawlies in general. B, violent confrontations. C, loved ones getting hurt or sick. D, it's not what you fear, but how you respond to the fear that counts. E, nothing scares me. I'm definitely not, what's the right word to describe E? Naive. I think I'm definitely not naive enough to think that nothing scares me, because I think that it does. Or D. I feel like it's more D, because it's not what you fear, but how you respond to that fear. Because I'm not really scared of, spiders or snakes or anything like that. Violent confrontations don't necessarily, I don't fear them. If I'm in one, then I guess I'm here. Time to survive. You better hit back. Or C, loved ones getting sick or hurt. Not really. I'm gonna go with D. Now, C, or number three, says, have you ever done anything you consider brave? Just once. B, all the time. No, I tend to play it safe. D, not that I can remember. Or E, a few times. I'm gonna go with a few times. Now, number four says, what is your most frequent nightmare? Being trapped or buried alive. Being helpless when I want to act. C, running from an unknown figure. D, falling from a great height. Or D, my teeth falling out. Now, this is really interesting, because I've had a dream where my teeth fall out and I freak out, but I haven't had it in a while, or at all, ever since I realized that if my teeth fall out, I can just get veneers and I'll be just fine. This isn't really a problem anymore. D, falling from a great height. I've actually had this dream plenty of times, and I used to, be scared of it, but then somehow, in these dreams, somehow, I fell, but then I flew, I started flying, so now I'm not really scared of it, because it's kind of cool, because when I fall in my dreams, I start flying out of nowhere. And being trapped or buried alive, I guess, yeah, that sucks, but, it's not like I'm constantly having a nightmare about it. I don't think I've ever had a nightmare about this. And then B says, being helpless when you want to act. Now, I can relate to this, but I have never had a nightmare about it. C, though, this is the one. Let me tell you guys a story. So, ever since I was a little girl, one. Now number five says, which of these activities would you like to do slash have you done? Donated blood, travel the world. I want to travel the world and do ASMR while I'm doing it. That's the ultimate goal. C, skydiving or bungee jumping, rock or mountain climbing. E, none of the above. I've done rock climbing. I hated it. It's a physical activity and it's not the activity for me. I much rather prefer like non energy draining activities. I hated rock climbing. Wait a second. Why the fuck did I just circle it? Oh my god, I'm like spacing out. No, I didn't mean that. I meant to travel. I meant to circle travel in the world. But I don't know why I did that. I couldn't stop thinking about that black figure, I guess. So I'm gonna go with travel the world because, I mean, I would like to donate blood, but I mean the goal is definitely travel the world. Okay, let's move on to the next page. Now number six is asking, pick the person you admire most for being brave. Martin Luther King Jr., Muhammad Ali, Mother Teresa, Rosa Parks. I can't choose just one. I'm gonna go with Martin Luther King Jr. I don't know why. It's just, I feel like he's definitely made a big, huge impact, and I mean, they all have, but his is the one that speaks out to me the most. Now, number seven is asking, what is the bravest act listened to below in your opinion? What is the bravest act listed below in your opinion? A, rescuing someone in danger. B, protecting your country. C, standing up to a bully. D, taking a stand against injustice. E, protecting and serving the community and residents. I'm gonna go with D, taking a stand against an injustice, because it's often that a lot of people don't stand up for what they believe in because it's not the popular thing to do, or it's not the norm. And if you can take a stand despite knowing that you're gonna be a very silent majority, but what looks like a minority, and you still do it, then that's bravery, because you're not a follower, you're a leader. Now number eight says, what trait does someone brave possess? A, integrity. B, courage. C, confidence. D, honesty. Or E, self-sacrifice. This is kind of hard. I would either go with courage or self-sacrifice. I mean, I don't know which one, courage or self-sacrifice. I'm gonna go with self-sacrifice because I feel like more people would have courage before they have self-sacrifice, and a lot of people wouldn't self-sacrifice. Or they would, but I mean, I feel like it's just, this one is like the ultimate bravery. Now number nine says, how brave would you rate yourself? A, average. B, above average. C, I need to learn how to be braver. D, depends on the situation. Or E, brave enough. I'm gonna go with depends on the situation, because there's some things I won't. Some things I wouldn't, like, stand up for, but then some things get my blood boiling, and 7, I got D. Number 6, I got A. Let's go back. Number 5, I got B. And number 4, I got C. Number 5, I got B. And number 4, I got C. Now, number 3. So I fall in this category, and it says, you are brave in any service of the greater good. You don't care if you get attention or acknowledgement for your good deeds. I think that's true, as long as you do what needs to be done to help as many people as possible. Maybe not this last part. I'd like to get there someday, though. Let's read the other ones just for fun. This one says, brave, but don't know it. You may be brave, but you don't know it yet because your bravery has never been put to the test. Given the chance, you would step up to the plate. I feel like I'm more in this category. Now, number 26 to 33. You are a bit below average in the bravery department and could use a good dose of self-confidence. You love stories of bravery, but you need to trust yourself and your abilities more. Know how valuable you are, so when the time comes, you can step up. Okay. 18 to 25. You are bold and brave and pride yourself on helping others. You respect bravery, but at times you can go out of the way to show off your boldness. Overtly brave. Oh, I see. Tone down the overzealousness and you will be just right. I guess a good would have been this one if I would have gotten 10 to 17, because it says you have a healthy level of bravery brewing inside of you. You don't go out of your way to excessive bravery, but in the right situation, you will be measured and you will surpass. I feel like this one would have been the best one to have, but I guess I'm a self-sacrificing do-gooder. I find that really funny, because nobody would agree with that. Nobody that I know, at least. But, yeah. So I hope you enjoyed this quiz. I really enjoy doing these. I feel like I say that in every video. But, like, these are fun to me. So I hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to take the quiz with me. Yeah, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel.